What's up guys, Peter here from Reviews on Anything, and today we are in my bedroom. On my bed, because we're reviewing my new head pillow. Now, a head pillow is not something you probably think about every day, but it is worth mentioning that you spend a lot of time on your pillow, obviously. All the time that you sleep, you're laying on your pillow. And it is, you know, 6, 7, 8, 9 hours a day. So it is actually worth it to get a proper pillow to prevent all kinds of, you know, neck issues, shoulder issues, back issues, and so on. I went for a pillow from a company called Silvana. And they have a whole range of pillows. It was actually quite, I wouldn't say mind-boggling, but quite something. When I got to the shop, I was like, yeah, I need a pillow. And they had this whole range of questions from how do you sleep, what kind of mattress do you have, how often do you sleep, how long do you sleep, do you sleep on your stomach, on your back, on your side, and so on. All in order to sort of tailor the choice of pillow to my sleeping needs. The one I went for is from the Royal line. That means a combination of natural and synthetic materials. It is the higher end line that they have. In that line they have soft, medium and firm, and I went for the firm version, which is special for people that are slightly larger than average, which is something that I am, and people that sleep on a hard mattress, which is something I do. I also sleep on my stomach and on my side sometimes, so that is also good for this kind of pillow. Now I got the pillow right here, with the face prints on it, as you can see. That is something that they have throughout their whole lineup. Not really necessary if you ask me, but you know, it identifies the pillow because their other lines go by color and so on. It is what it is, nothing to be done. You don't see it anyway because you have molten over it, obviously to soak up any sweat, and you have a pillowcase over it on top of that, so you don't see it or feel it at all. But the pillow is, you know, quite a work of art, I wouldn't say, but quite the piece of engineering. You can tell, for example, that it has a wedge underneath here to fit your shoulders and your neck better. It's actually a pillow that consists of several compartments. First you have the wedge here on the bottom, which is obviously to support your neck. Then you have the sides that are slightly harder than the middle, which is slightly softer for proper head support, meaning your spine aligns properly in order to have the best sleeping position, the most healthy sleeping position for both, you know, your neck, shoulders, and your back. So this particular line is the Royal line, like I said, it's the high-end line that they have, which means that the bottom here is made out of latex, so that's the support part for your neck, the wedge, so you will. The top part here is made of 90% Dow. And they also are very proud saying that they have a special certification that it's sort of animal-friendly type of Dow, which is always nice. So it's a combination of two materials resulting in a pillow that is cool, doesn't warm up too much, and is still comfortable but very supportive at the same time. And because of the different compartments and the different stiffnesses and hardnesses of the materials, you are sort of in a very natural position with your head in order for the perfect sleep alignment. The downside obviously is that you can't wash it. This is not machine washable in any way, shape, or form. Also, it is refillable, if that's a word. So this is it. This is it. This is the pillow. There's nothing really you can do about this pillow once you purchase it. It is treated with a material that kills sort of dust mites and so on. But they really recommend that you obviously put a molten over it to catch up most of the sweat that you will produce at night, and then obviously a pillowcase like this one, to soak up any whatever drool or whatever might come out of you, to keep the pillow in good shape for as long as possible. You do get 2-year warranty, which is something that's very nice, and they say that in general you should have a pillow for 4 to 5 years max, and then it's time for a new one, because especially a pillow like this, which is not washable, you know, it's gonna get dirtier over time anyway, no matter how well you treat it with the molten and the pillowcase. So now a bit more up close with the pillow. The most important thing to note, obviously, is the shape and the construction of the pillow, with the wedge here on the bottom and the head part here on the top. That means, first and foremost, that you can't turn this pillow around like so, because then obviously you just have the head part and the support part is on the top where your neck isn't. So the only way you can turn this pillow around is sideways. So, you know, something to take into consideration. The wedge here is quite interesting, because obviously this is the part where your neck will be laying. You can see that it has a bit of an indentation here. So when you sleep on it like so, your shoulder fits in perfectly and your neck is supported here on the bottom and your head goes here in the middle. Perfect fit. It has 90% DAO inside, like I said, which does compress slightly, and it also does require a bit of fluffing at least every day. Easy to go though, you can just, you know, pop the pillow a bit and you can actually feel that it gets a bit firmer. Now the middle part is slightly softer than the side parts, so depending on how you sleep, that might be something you have to adjust to slightly. The dent here does mean that you can't really move around that much in and outside the pillow, so you're pretty sort of focused on laying properly on the pillow, which is something to get used to a little bit if you come from a pillow like I did that was just, you know, universally pillow shaped, I suppose. You can pretty much lay in any position. Here the pillow forces you to lay onto the pillow a certain way, which is not a bad thing, but it is something to get used to. Because it does that, it can sort of put you in the correct position much better. So it's actually, I think, kind of smart that they made this shape in such a way that you have to lay on it in a certain way in order to make it more comfortable and better for your spine and your neck and your shoulders and so on. Now I lay on it sideways like this, in the middle mostly, but you can imagine that when I sleep on my stomach, I move over slightly to the side just to make it more comfortable. And also then, the indentation here and the ridge, the wedge here on the bottom, makes it really comfortable for my shoulders. They fit in nice and tight, and it supports my neck at the same time, so everything is nice and straight once again. Now, because it's made of ductile and latex, the pillow stays nice and cool, which is something I find really important. I hate it to get hot when I'm sleeping. It depends a little bit on the pillowcase you're using, obviously, and the molten. But the pillow itself stays nice and cool, which is great. And overall adds to the whole experience of, you know, a comfortable night rest. Are there any downsides to this pillow? Well, it's expensive. I'll get to that in a second. The flipping over, you know, that you can only do it this way and not that way, it's not really an issue, just something you have to remember. But, you know, as soon as you flip it over the wrong way, you'll notice instantly. And I don't think this pillow lends itself well for pillow fights. So if that's your kind of thing, this is probably not the pillow for you either. Other than that, I think it's a great pillow with, you know, properly used materials and some proper thoughts behind the shape and the construction of the pillow, which is obviously contributing to a good night's sleep. So I've been sleeping on this pillow for a couple of weeks now, so what do I make of it? Well, it's something to get used to a little bit, because I had a set of, let's say, a traditional pillow before, so not with the structure and the wedge shape and so on. But I have to say, like, after one or two nights, it felt completely natural already, and it's actually quite comfortable. And I do really notice a difference in the way I wake up. I sleep on my stomach mostly, meaning obviously that my back has a bit of an arch. That's why I have a hard mattress, but the pillow makes a big difference. It's slightly flatter than my previous pillow, but still offers more support, meaning that the angle at which I lay on the mattress is much better for my lower back. So I have noticeably less sort of stiffness in the morning thanks to this pillow. It is super comfortable. It makes me sleep, you know, like a baby, I would say, but I in general sleep pretty good. It gives me all the support that I need, especially around my neck. I'm slightly wider in the shoulders than the average person, I suppose, which makes it, you know, important that my head has proper support in my neck as well, which the wedge and the sort of the whole sleeping area really provide. So in terms of comfort and sleeping comfortable, awesome, 10 points. Is it worth it though? That's up for debate, I'd say. This is a 159 euro pillow, which is, no matter how you twist and turn it, a lot of money. Add to that a 15 euro molten if you don't have it. You know, you're well into the 170s. And that's expensive. That's just what it is. For me personally, I think it's worth it, because considering the amount of time you spend on a pillow and how important night rest is, I don't mind spending that kind of money on a good product that I spend so much time on. On the other hand, it is a lot of money, and they have, you know, their normal range, their fully synthetic range, they're good pillows too. So you can definitely save yourself 50, 60 euro and go for one of those and still have a very comfortable experience. I like the slightly higher end one in this case, because it's just nice, fits all my needs and provides me with a great experience. So, you know, obviously I didn't know that beforehand, but, you know, having slept on this pillow for a couple of weeks now, I think it's totally worth it. This is Peter from Reviews on Anything with a look at the Silvana Royal Firm Pillow. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to the channel. That always helps us out a lot. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Cheers!